Chairman and David both worked on are the supplements and some greens arrangements, a very natural-looking design. So I'm going to do one for you right now. But, you know, supplements have been a real strong part of the design, whether it's in wedding bouquets or everyday bouquets. Somebody told me last year that succulents are a sign of wealth and prosperity. I think that's why it took off and became so popular in wedding bouquets and things like that. One thing we're seeing already this year, though, I think the newest trend is for an item called Tillandsia, T-I-L-L-A-N-D-S-I-A. Tillandsia is more commonly known as the air plant. You know, sometimes you see them at novelty stores where they put it on a piece of driftwood or bark and it grows and you just have to mist it. Well, unfortunately, though, air plants are a little harder to come by than succulents. You know, whenever you don't want them, they're everywhere, right? Like, the other day, I had a designer who wanted them, and I couldn't find them anywhere. I went to dollar stores, garden centers, everything. Nobody had anything. But then I substituted, we have this beautiful artificial tillandsia. $375 for two, and it's perfect, and it's a great price point. But we were able to use that instead. So we see a little bit of a trend there already starting, where we're going from the succulents and the chicks and hens, so to speak, and we're moving over to Tillandsia design. Really does give it a more gardeny feel, very natural feel, a vegetative feel. So anyway, that's just a trend that we see coming. One of the things with the plants that I like to focus on is a variety of greens, whether and not just greens as in types of foliage, but in colors of foliage as well. So I have this fern frond that has a bit of an olive color to it. I'm going to start with that. And then this stick, I don't know what it is, I'm just going to call it a stick. It's kind of a cool stick. Looks like a plant that just lost all its foliage, probably in the recent Michigan freeze, right? I kind of cheated a little because David had to leave unexpectedly. He had some business back at the store and he was hoping his mom was going to take care of it. But then he couldn't get a hold of his mom because his mom got a new phone and accidentally blocked herself out. So he had to go and make sure everything was okay. So I ran back to the store, found out everything was okay, and came back. So in the meantime, I went into a little bit of a panic and I started cutting the proper stuff. So maybe I get enough stuff done, it'll be okay. But as you can see, he made it back. Everything's good. Mom's good. Home's good. I think we're seeing a real return with plants. Especially, I think people are looking for things that are more natural, earth-friendly. And even though the permanent botanicals might not be natural and real, they are more earth-friendly because you can just make one and then have it and hang on to it, right? So there is some benefit to that. Obviously, you know, at first, when these plastic plants came out, I saw those and I thought, really? I mean, we used those back in the 70s when we had to, right? We really didn't want to. But now it's a nice texture, it's a nice difference, whether you're putting it with ivies or silk sword ferns or whatever. It works out pretty well. But you can do some really neat things with the plastics. And I'll show you a flower in a minute that was done in plastic. And from a distance, I dare you to know that it's plastic. It's really pretty cool. I'll show you that in a few more minutes. And like, check out that one. That one's a plastic one too. But now, this one is that darker green, and this one is more of that gray green too. So we get a nice, unusual variance in green. David, that's a cool plant. That container David's using, it doesn't look like the end of a hair dryer, not a hair dryer, but a dryer hair. Like that little crimped edge, and they made a really cool distressed metal series of containers in different shapes and sizes that we have. Is that a good pretty good price point on those,
David?
$10.30. That's a nice. I do glue. Most of the time with any type of foliage or permanent botanicals, I try to glue everything in because I want it to be permanent. I don't want to have any issues later. On some of the next arrangement I was going to do for you, I actually spiked a lot of things ahead of time and gave it to got the pick machine over there. I think a pick machine is almost like a lost art. So many people don't use it anymore, but they really are handy, quick and easy. So we have a nice little discharge, real quick and easy.
It's 12-inch container. We have them in like three different sizes, that ceramic container. It's really well done.
I don't know what the price on this one is offhand. We did import that one, so that worked out pretty well. Kim took one of the apothecary jars, flipped the lid, she glued it, so I'm not going to touch. She just used some Oasis dots on the lid, flipped it upside down, did her terrarium inside. Again, notice the Tillandsia. She's used in a couple different areas on that apothecary jar. And when she flipped it over, she had a succulent or two, become more Tillandsia. What's supposed to look like a fresh lotus pot, right? I love the little baby tears. Those are pretty up front. And then just a little bit of the paper wrap wire for entry to add on to the Tillandsia. I think it just kind of extends that look throughout the whole thing. Very clean and easy. Anybody who's ever tried to do a terrarium like this, you know that you run into issues with the condensation, right? If you get a lot of condensation here, you gotta kind of measure out how much air you're gonna give the plants, etc. Here you don't have to worry about it. And really, from where you're sitting, doesn't it look like it's fresh and natural? It's a beautiful piece, isn't it? Just dust it off every couple of weeks and good to go. I really like the cement container that Kim chose. It has a wide base, but it has a much smaller opening at the top, so you don't have to fill the whole thing, so to speak. She's added a little bit of the succulent material here, and some curly wool just for look and texture. Also, given some size, right? I think always, size makes a difference in the design. If you do a beautiful arrangement and it's only this big, there's a presumed value that it's going to be less expensive. Even though maybe it's only this big and it has garden roses and peonies and all the most expensive flowers, people still only expect to pay X amount. So if you can extend it just a little bit, or using the branches and things like that, I think it helps to get to a different value point. And these artificial cactus, I think they're so well done. I think, I mean, really anybody, I challenge them when they come into your store or look at your arrangement and go, wow, those are fresh. And the other thing that lends itself really well to the natural botanicals is the reindeer ones. You just tuck that in and finish it off. That way you don't have the dust or mess with the green moss or reindeer moss or Spanish moss, I'm sorry. And then even the Kim's added one of the supplements down there at the base. So it makes for a nice texture. This one, it looks like a finished ceramic or cement pot, but it's actually some type of mix. So it's probably got fiberglass in it, a little bit of powder with that gray finish. So it's not real lightweight, but it's much lighter than if it was all cement. Kim's added, again, used a little bit of the corkscrew wool to extend it. We have some Tillandsia sprinkled in, some little grapevine orbs. And Kim's also used, you can see, some milk pods and some other dry pods in there to give it a little bit different look, to mix in with the greens and the grays of the succulents and give it some more depth as well. A little bit of the sedum added in as well. And now the price is coming down a little bit. I mean, some of the succulents are running from $350 to $550, I think, for most of them. They put a bag of assorted succulents for about $10. So I think for about $20 you can make up an arrangement like this. For those of you who aren't familiar with the cost of fresh succulents will run $5 to $7.50 a stem all by themselves. So the artificial or permanent botanicals are actually very cost effective. They're almost less expensive than the real thing. But yet they still give you a beautiful look. You like that? As everyone hopefully remembers Tom from last season, but we do videotape all our shows and Tom breaks them up into 15-minute segments, so we show them on our website later if you want to refresh your memory or show a customer something, we'll have that later. The other thing we'll do too is we'll have photos taken of all the arrangements and us on Facebook yet, please do. We always have some really interesting and new things out there every week. And we're going to leave the arrangements up from this morning until this afternoon, so you have plenty of time afterwards if you want to take some personal photographs as well. Here's another question on that. The bowl that I just showed you there is a set of three or four. And it's always the biggest one and the smallest one that are the last to sell. Everybody wants the middle size. And no sooner did we get them in, we got about 24 sets, than somebody came in and took 24 of the medium bowl right out of the set. So it's like, well, what do you do? Because everybody has different needs. I think these, the larger ones, will make really cool porch pots for Mother's Day. You know, you can take those and give them to your greenhouse that will make them up for you. And, you know, for some little more contemporary look on a traditional porch or for patio or for backyard, I think that's a great pot. And it is all season, so a really different one. Kids use the rest of that corkscrew willow branch a bunch. She's very good at that. You know, and as designers, I think we should be too, is if you start to break into a bunch, finish off making arrangements until you're finished with the bunch. That way you make sure you use the whole value. By the time you get to the last few pieces, that's actually a lot of profit for you because you've used the majority of the cost already. Now you're adding on two or three small things where you're just using the branches and then you make up the difference. Beautiful air ferns. I always call it this. I don't know what my mother-in-law told me, right? It's funny, years ago my mom had one. She had an old clay pot that she had for years and years and years. And she got it to flower. And I guess it's very difficult, but they do flower. They're a beautiful spike. Came right out of the center and had lavender flowers. Kind of strange remember, I was just a kid at the time. But I worked as a boss, my boss at the time, Floyd, said, you know, Christy, we can just make anything come to life. And it was really beautiful. It was very nice. A few other mixed foliages, some more of these succulents hanging down. I just love them. I think they're a great look. And if you're using them in a permanent botanical, or if you're using them in a wedding bouquet, what's going to be? Nobody's going to know that's not real. They'll argue about it, so that's not real. Yes, it is. You don't know what you're talking about. It's real. But it really does give it a little different look. And again, the boards. You know, the boards add something to a design, but they don't add a lot of cost, right? If I put another fern in here to take the place of the boards, that's going to cost me $10 or $15, right, for a nice fern. But the orb is what, $2, $3, so you really have a cost saving there, but you add value at the same time. And Kim has finished it all the way around, so if it does work as a patio pot, or let's say you use it in a lobby of a hotel or a restaurant, it has something to see all the way around. It's like a big fish tanks up at Rainforest Cafe at Great Lakes Crossing, you can see it from all the way around. Kim's added a couple of the sponge mushrooms to the base over here in the corner, as well as a couple of dry pods. There's a couple more pods for texture tucked in here as well. So no matter where you look at it, it starts to draw your interest, right? So many times I think people think of plants as just filler and not really designs. But if you design a beautiful piece like this, and honestly, I love the porch pots with the fresh flowers and the fresh vines in them because they're always very different and fun. So when you're making something like this, it's going to be permanent. Why not add some interest all the way around?